He is a cock destroyer.
For me.
Cock destroyer. A big fucking cock destroyer. You are. You put it right away. Go on, do it.
With their big lips and even bigger breasts, Rebecca Moore and Sophie Anderson jumped onto the scene and coined themselves the Cock Destroyers with their OnlyFans advertising. They are such great supporters of the LGBTQ plus community, and Sophie Anderson has even come out as bisexual, so snaps to that. And in 2020, they started their own British online reality show, Slag Wars, the search for the next destroyer to find the next Cock Destroyer. If you're watching this, just like your device, you're about to be turned on. Please welcome the Cock Destroyers. Icons, thank you so much for joining us on Logo Live. I can't tell you, I'm not worthy. We're not worthy to have you. Thank you for joining us.
Oh, we're over the moon, aren't we, Safe? We were talking about this. So thanks for us, Johnny.
Amazing.
Slag Wars, please. Yes. So we love the idea of Slag Wars. Can you... Explain it for the dumb Americans what Slag Wars is and what slag even means.
Slag Wars to us is a reality show. We wanted something. Everybody was saying, oh, we want you to do something. You need to do a reality show. You need to do it. And we were like, yes, how can we do a reality show that welcomes everyone in? And the word slag we use as a real positive thing, a real positive thing. We're like, this is like a British word, but it's actually positive to us. And actually that is very empowering for the adult and the sex industry. So I myself think the show, and I know Rebecca will agree with me on this, it's a show that is sex positive, it is race positive, it's trans community positive, it's the LGBT positive, and it's the non-binary. And you have all these people that we managed to handpick in this amazing show, and it's very, very positive. And that's exactly what we wanted to show, and it has done. So
yeah, I love that. And the reception has been so great. I would like to ask, the reception being so great, is that something that you expected? For, you know, it's a subversive show, something that people wouldn't expect, but it's been so well received. What would you say to that? Like, were you expecting it? Like, how do you feel about that?
I think we knew we had created something absolutely fantastic. And we knew people would love it because we loved it so much. We were so behind this, but to be honest, we are blown away with the amazing response. The press that we had has been phenomenal. We couldn't have asked for such delights of coverage. We've been blown away by that side of things. And so it spurred us on to really fight for more series. Like, this is our thing now, isn't it? And come hell or shine, we will be going off. We're not just going to leave number one here. We're like, right, we can do bigger and better now. And so this is our little baby. And thanks to men.com, who is known for their porn site, you know, got on board with this and have been fantastic. Or we wouldn't be having this conversation if it wasn't for them. So we appreciate that. And me and Sophie, like, we've got visions of like getting to season 13,
yes.
Whatever. So yeah, there's so much more that we want to do. But yeah, sex positivity has been very, very important for us because of our backgrounds and just taking ownership of your sexuality. We do want it to, I think you can learn something as well. We want it to become quite educational as well as fun and smutty and dirty and raw and everything, and just giving people one more contestant as well next time. You know, I feel that four of them, like four shows wasn't enough. I'd love to see more contestants on for a lot longer and just keep going till everybody is sick of it.
One of the things I love, love, love about you both is that, you know, when you first popped onto the scene, you are so sex positive and so just so endearing. And I will say, seeing your stars rise, it really has shifted a conversation that has been going on for a long time about sex positivity, the adult film industry, and OnlyFans creators. So what can you say? How do you feel about what's changing even since you popped onto the scene?
It's a real funny thing because I see the cock destroyers as a movement. I really have, since we both came and we're like, yeah, you know, this is us, you know,
I mean, people slag you want to pay. We made it more acceptable. Everybody's just come out of the woodwork like, yeah, fucking
isn't that so true? But like, everybody does this now. Everybody,
you see them in the supermarket.
It's like, you know, we're not just sex workers. We're not just porn stars. And that's the thing. What we want is there is this still this boundary between sex work and kind of mainstream. And the thing is that we want to show that you can do both. And yeah, that's what we're doing. I mean, we've got our own production company. We, you know, Rebecca's YouTube. We're doing funny comedy on there. You know, we've got our OnlyFans. There is possibilities not just to be a sex worker.
The whole reason that video, that film came about, that the viral one, was because Sophie and I lived in a bubble. We had a protective shell around us because of what people thought and things, yeah, like that. And we just didn't give a shit anymore. We needed to get the 6 foot bang, bang, and we were out to make money. So, you know, we didn't care about what people thought. And we had this kind of protective suit over us. And when we made, yeah, that video, obviously we got a lot more than we bargained for, because every gay in everywhere came, not every gay, but, you know, everybody came for us, and in a nice, amazing way. And like,
yeah,
we... was. To be called a gay icon still to this day is like one of the most amazing things I could have ever been called.
The queer community, we have our icons like Mariah and Whitney. How does it feel to be one of our divas now?
It's the best thing ever, because when I phoned Sophie and I said, I've had 6 gay guys inbox me and call me a gay icon. This is like the best thing ever. Like Kylie, the first person I thought of was Kylie. I was like, Kylie is like the gay icon. I went, yeah, like, I don't know if this, and then more people get saying it. And it's such an honor. It really is, because we are used to being put on a pedestal by straight guys for lusting after us and you know, for all the obvious things, yeah, that we are very much used to, aren't we, Sophie? And so, you know, we were kind of like, we didn't really have anything to offer gay guys. Like, obviously, we do. We are apparently funny. So,
as two sexual beings, what advice can you give us about still getting off while being in a pandemic?
We've got thousands of boyfriends on OnlyFans, like virtual, right, boyfriends. They pay us. They show us their dicks. They actually want to know what we're doing for the day. They're like, are you all right? You know, so
we don't even want us to say their names.
Yeah, you know, like we are having a bit of a party in our OnlyFans. We've created communities. I think since the pandemic happened, it became a bit more, didn't it, Sophie? They were our lifeline as well, in the sense of keeping us sane. I've become a bit of an online girlfriend as well to many of them, and we talk about all sorts of things, and it keeps me out of trouble. Yeah, and that's it. I this is the driest period I've ever had.
We're like,
I have a game for you all. So, speaking of the LGBTQ plus community, we couldn't talk about the community without talking about our goddesses, our drag queens. And I know that our drag queens love you, and I know that you love them. So this game is what something I'd like to call Cock Destroyer or Slag in Training. I'm going to give you the name of a drag queen. And you're going to have 10 seconds to tell me if they're a Cock Destroyer or a Slag in Training. Are you ready?
Yeah. Oh, God.
All right. The first drag queen we have is Katya.
Oh, Cock Destroyer.
Cock Destroyer.
Fucking Cock Destroyer. Babe, yeah. You look like Katya tonight. Sometimes I look like Katya. Sometimes,
oh my God.
We both like to pretend we're Katya and Trixie at times.
Ooh, Trixie Mattel.
A total Cock Destroyer. They are. I reckon they're utter filth.
Yeah, utter filth.
Bob the drag queen.
Cock Destroyer.
Cock Destroyer.
I mean, this is so obvious. So obvious. We first spoken to Bob. Said,
oh, yeah.
Alaska.
Oh, Cox Destroyer. Utter filth. Utter filth, that one.
Monet Exchange.
Oh, tricky one, actually. I reckon Cox Destroyer. Okay, you're a massive Cox Destroyer.
Michelle Visage.
Oh, a complete Cox Destroyer. Yeah. Never even did any training. Was just like,
she was born a Cox Destroyer.
Head first, looped up.
Bianca Del Rio.
Slag in training.
Yeah.
Slag in training.
You're from the UK. You watch UK's Drag Race. What are your thoughts on the Cox Destroyers?
What do we think of them? We think they're great. We had Bagger on the show.
Yeah.
Fantastic. But I wish Blue Hydrator can stop stealing my one-liners.
Yeah, come on now.
He spun their balls, darling.
Okay, anytime I walk into a party, when I used to go out to parties, but I would walk in and be like, Hi, guys. And the gays would love. What are you planning when the pandemic is over? How are you going to celebrate?
We've already discussed it, haven't we?
We are definitely going to be, we're going to go in gently. Maybe. And then we're going to go a little bit crazy because I'm actually buying a second house and I've already planned it, right? Once we're out safe, we're going to get a few boys around, aren't we? Because I can use this place as like a sex den. But I'm very sensible. Yeah. I'm going to make sure that COVID's completely gone. I don't think it is. So I think this is all just going to be a bit of a dream.
A fantasy.
We're going to be planning this. What we could do is we could sell the tickets, Sophie, and be like, you can cash them in once COVID's gone.
Exactly. We're going to end up with hundreds and thousands, don't we, in one party.
I know. I do have a glory hole here as well.
Work.
It's very big. So you can fit several cocks in there.
We love
a sandwich.
Anyway, you're ticking all the boxes.
I digress.
So now, when you're not, you know, being sexual animals and just making the world a better place, what do you do at home? Are there any TV shows you're watching at the moment? Any music that you're loving?
I've become very good at eating in this pandemic, so I've decided to put that into good effort. I'm going to become a sushi genius. I made my first sushi last night.
Oh.
And I'm vegan, right? So that just makes it even more complicated. So I'm going to become shit hot at making sushi rolls, and I'm going to have a sushi night and stuff like that. What else have I done that's... So over here we've got this... I'm addicted. So you know when you sit in front of someone, you've got to do like a review. I'm so good at... I was like, if I was on Gogglebox or something, this would be the only show that I could possibly review to this excellence. Celebs Go Dating. Celebs Go Dating, right?
It's
effing well amazing. I'm addicted. It's really old stuff. So it's post-pandemic. Honestly, you wouldn't believe how shite some celebrities are at dating. But also I'm waiting for, we've got Drag Race UK coming out on Thursday. I'm gonna binge watch that and the American one all together.
Ooh, yes. I can't wait for the pandemic to be fully over so I can go across the pond and join you in your big sex den and just have the best
time. And we're hopefully gonna be coming back over to Slag Wars over in LA.
Oh my God, yes.
Yeah.